Hey there, Christina here, and I wanted to give you a quick lay of the land here in Phoenix so you can see on the map. Although we call all of this Phoenix, there are a number of smaller cities. And before I get into that, I'm going to quickly point out a few of the colleges. We're sort of known for ASU, Arizona State University. ASU's main campus is in Tempe, and Tempe, one of the smaller cities, is part of the greater Phoenix area. It's really known as a college town. We've got Grand Canyon University, which has been growing a lot. They've been buying property and building new dormitories and classrooms, and that's kind of just on the west side of the 17 right here. Just a couple of the community colleges. There are definitely more, but just kind of laying out the few that I'm most familiar with. We've got Glendale Community College in Glendale, Paradise Valley Community College in North Phoenix, Northeast Phoenix, and then we've got Scottsdale Community College in sort of the South Scottsdale area. And so if we're looking at the map, just to point out a couple of the highways, you can see we've got the 101 that sort of runs around the northern part of the Phoenix metro area. Well, I'm going to point out before I get to the other highways, there's a road that kind of runs through central Phoenix here, and the road is called Central Avenue. Everything to the west side of Central Avenue is considered West Phoenix, and then on the east side, especially everything over here, when people say east side, they're generally referring to Tempe, Mesa, Gilbert, Chandler, Queen Creek, Apache Junction. But everything over here is also considered the east side. Our roads were planned very well, and our major roads really do run in a grid, north, south, east, and west. Everything on the west side of Central Avenue is an avenue. So starting out here, we're in the hundreds, and it works its way down. Right around here, you're around 35th Avenue. You keep going, Third Avenue, and then you get to Central Avenue. And then as it keeps going east, you're in the streets. So you've got First Street, Second Street, Seventh Street is a major road. Seventh Street is one of the streets that you can take from downtown to North Phoenix without dead ending into a mountain. A lot of the roads and streets don't go through just because there are a number of mountains through the valley here that kind of get in the way. If you're new to the area, I think it's good to know you've got avenues on the west side, streets on the east side, and then you'll typically see there, let's just say the street name is Monte Cristo. If it's on the west side of Central Avenue, it'll be West Monte Cristo. If it's on the east side of Central Avenue, it'll be East Monte Cristo. So kind of looking at our different towns here, we've got Goodyear, Avondale, Buckeye. These towns are growing, they're developing, they really are their own cities. Your money will go a little further in these towns because they are a little bit of a drive outside of the Central Phoenix area. You would take the 10 in, the 10. Now, compared to other cities, Phoenix traffic is probably not as bad as some of the other major cities in the United States, but the 10 does happen to be one of our busier roads. The 10, if you keep going on it, will take you to California, and if you're driving it in rush hour, we have HOV lanes, so if you're driving with another person, it's not going to be too bad because you can ride in the HOV lane. If you're driving on your own, it can take you considerably longer amount of time to get somewhere during rush hour from those parts of town. Then let's see, so we have Phoenix in the center here, Peoria up here on the northwest side of the city, and then Glendale in the middle. Let's see, Paradise Valley is considered to be one of the most prestigious parts of town here. Very expensive homes. Scottsdale is a little bit in the same way. It does tend to have more expensive homes. As you get further outside of the 101, everything kind of up here outside of the 101 is considered to be fairly far from the center of the city. Let me point out the airport, Phoenix Sky Harbor, is right here in between the 10 and the 202. So it's a good little drive to get out here. Some of the pluses to living out there is also your money will go a little further, but you can also get a little bit more land. Phoenix is sort of known for having smaller yards compared to some other parts of the country. But as you get up north of the 101, you're more likely to find acreage. It is going to be desert property. So when you get acreage, it costs a lot to water a lawn. So acreage tends to be a lot of desertscape. Let's see, what else do I want to tell you about the town? Ahwatukee down here, really cute little town. Each of these cities really is kind of a city in their own right. Ahwatukee has its own restaurants and movie theaters and things to do. One of the reasons that I hear people telling me that they don't want to live in Ahwatukee is currently there's really just one highway in and out of town. So if you were trying to get over here on the west side, you'd have to come up the 10, go around. But they are actually working on building another highway. So that's going to change. So anyways, that's kind of the area. And if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks so much.